place the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand and let us sing together number 385, our opening hymn.
Thank you.
believers and hope in the world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, that we may follow your commands and proclaim your reign of love through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. For this reason, the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot. And those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. You are in the Spirit, since the Spirit of God dwells in you. Anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, though the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is life because of righteousness. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his Spirit that dwells in you. Here ends the reading. Please stand.
Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him,
"Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her weep also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, already there is a stench, because he's been dead 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone, and Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe you sent me." When he had said this, he cried with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out!" The dead man came out, his hands and his feet bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." Many of the Jews, therefore, who had come with Mary and had seen what Jesus did, believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Horizon. Everything is possible until death comes, and
nothing is possible except decay and stench. But Paul would have us set our mind on the Spirit, which sees farther than that, has a broader horizon. Death is not the final word, because Jesus is the resurrection and the life. And so that's what Paul puts before us. Are you going to focus your mind on what your human flesh is capable of, which is limited? Limited finally and ultimately by death. Or are you going to set your mind on